Hello everybody, my name is Zenk Nox and welcome to another Idreos video. Today we'll be checking out the new hero, Shaho. I build a team around him. So we will be using Asmodel with 95% block, SFX with 70%, Russell with 70%. He has 103% block. And then I am assuming we are using like a Fiona because that's the most block I have on another hero. And the last one is Eloise with 85% block. So yeah, we'll be trying to block everything and try to get as many stacks as possible. I'm not gonna do broken spaces because we already know he is bad there. We will try doing some Realms Gate, Void Vortex and Tower, I think. This one I don't have much stamina either because I put him in the mine on the last map before I built him to E5, so yeah, I needed to finish that. But yeah, we will see what happens. So we are not using carry, we built Eloise, probably in the front, something like that. Again, our builds are like not the best. I just try to lower my damage and rely on the enemies to hit us and block them. So this one you see is the active of Shaho. It gives the team block, I think 35% right now. And it is 40% at V4. So after they start attacking more, I think we need like one more block maybe after this counter attack. Yep, there we go. So this is the armor and attack buff of Shaho. It is now, I think, is that three? I think it is three because these are six on him. He gets double on himself. So right now we have three stacks. Oh, it is now 4-4, I believe. I can't really read it. yeah, so 4-4, that's 80% armor and 80% attack bonus. And if the other two guys didn't die, it could be even more. You basically want your enemies to hit you multiple times, like that carry, she hit 4 people. And we have like 5 or 6. I believe that is 6. Yeah, these are 6 buffs. It dropped to 3, I guess that was the round 2. Since they all use active on round 2, you get a lot of stacks. And he is dead, so I mean, that wasn't, it's not the best test because this is low corruption level. He'll be skipping that. He himself doesn't do any damage. He is using, oh, I can't really test anymore. Oh, never mind, I got one more stamina. So I'm using, what am I using on him? Oh yeah, I am using Demon Bell on him. Because you want to get the active off to have more block chance on the team. You kinda want round one active. And I don't have energy feed right now, so he has to use the Demon Bell. We have 2-2 right now. 2 attack, 2 defense. I mean, it's always the same on them because they last the same amount of rounds. So we have 2 stacks. 3 right now. And they are overridden from the debuffs, but they are still there. I think we have 5. Yeah. Like 100% more attack is pretty good. I don't know if. Does AMB stack with that? Like extra attack passives? In that case, like, using AMB on your whole team will make them invincible? Invincible? I can't speak. Right? I don't know if that works. Anyway, we will try some. This is also just Valiant, so it's not the best. we will just put whatever. We are not using Tix or Rogan. There we go. And while this fight plays, you can check the buffs. I wanna talk about the broken spaces. The new levels, The eighth one has Kerry and Tara. So Tara only hits one enemy with both his passive and active attacks, which is pretty bad for Shaho. And Kerry only hits one target with her basic. And by the way, we died quite faster. We had two stacks. Didn't really work out. We are missing. I guess we have too low of an HP, right? Like not having enough HP makes it pretty hard to tank them. Anyway, so that wave is pretty hard because Shaho can get sealed. He can die very fast. And you don't really block a lot of attacks since Tara only hits one enemy. And the enemy only has two bosses anyway, so not like the Ramsgate or Void Vortex where you have six enemies in front of you. So it's not really working there, just wanted to say it. And on the ninth boss, there's also Drake, which ignores armor. So the armor you get from Shaho, even if you can get it, it's very hard to get it, is not working out. So in most scenarios, seems like Erogan does better, like way better than Shaho. I don't know about high level Ramsgate, because in those kind of fights, you can't one shot them. Unless we have a lot of home buffs, I guess, from the tenants. It's pretty hard to one shot them. But at the same time, this team only has two heroes that are imprinted. The other four are just E5, so very weak heroes actually. As you can see, they just all die. Hey, I think Rogan is probably better in most places. Let's do some towers. Do I wanna do some up heroes? Maybe Eloise? Let's try Eloise this and what are the other up heroes? There's a Garuda. I'm missing one. Oh, Voldek. Do I have a Voldek? Yes, I do. Did I not open it before? Nope. So yeah, I wanna open that. We want to get the maximum rewards here, so there we go. And now we will try Eloise and the new hero. Yeah, that works. So I believe he will be more powerful in teams with more artifacts. And way more imprints than this. Because an E5 hero nowadays is like the old 10 stars compared to when the first E5 happened. It's a lot of difference between imprinted and E5 heroes. I can't test him in PvP right now. You kind of want to make him fast, so that will mean a lot of imprints. I can't do that, I don't have the fodder. By the time he gets to use his active, he's usually dead. Or it doesn't work at all because some enemies have precision, especially the trans heroes with the imprints. And also, like, Asmodal gains a lot of precision when people die. Was that it? I think. And there's also a lot of passive damage in PvP. So, like, you get Halora counterattack. I mean, the Queen's Guard attacking you. And then, like, SFX counterattacks. There's a lot of things that do damage without actually attacking you. Right now, I think we have three stacks. It's down to one. We will see more in the nightmare levels, I guess. But yeah, I'm thinking like Realms Gate level 101 and tower levels are where he can be used, maybe. Because for pushing Void Vortex, you don't want your enemies to hit you at all. That's why you want to kill them in two rounds with SFX. Or at like Vanquisher, you want to CC them so they don't hit you. Because even V4 heroes just die to one hit from like Garuda or Kerry. It's very hard to tank them. Yeah, by the way, these Garudas doing a lot of damage with their passives. Right now we have two stacks. Yeah, it's still two. Oh, the Morax just killed him. Can these Gardas kill the Eloise with their actives? Not yet. Do we win this? I have no idea. I guess she can tank Garudas here. They are pretty weak. Like, she only has basic crown and doesn't have any imprint, so. It's a miracle that she even kills them. They should be pretty weak here in normal tower levels. I don't think these guys can hurt us, really. Except the 5 stars dying, of course. So maybe I should just get to the nightmare levels because these look very weak. 6 Taras. That might be interesting, yeah. I thought because all three of our heroes rely on their passives to do damage. And getting sealed is not the best thing when you rely on passive. Like, that always is not gonna do any damage this fight. I will just use, like, actually, they can stay, like, where is it? I'll just get through here with Asmodel, I guess. And now we will try going with Eloise. You can also see the E5 Eloise. It's the first time I built her. Just seeing her the first time. So I kinda wanna watch the fights as well. I might even wanna imprint her, like. But at the same time, I kinda wanna build and push Vortex. I mean, I need to build a Drake for that. Oh, the Shah. She just hit us like 8 times. Okay. Yeah, we'll just get to the Nightmare, I think. Oops. Really? Do you want me to use SFX? Okay. Let's get to the nightmare levels, and then we can use full team. Uh-oh. I kinda need Ignis here. So I will remove him, use Ignis. There we go. That's out of Sherlock's. Can I just get there, please? Thank you. No? Oh, I think I'm dying to Penny. Okay. Really? Okay, you know what? Whatever. So let's try these new levels now. We are using that, that, here. And I guess something like that. Yeah, they are faster than us. That's not the best scenario. We kind of needed the actor from Shaho there. So far, we have one stack, we have two stacks, and he is dead. Everyone is dead. Okay. That was fast. I think I can get that done with attribute reduction and Ignis behind SFX. Let's try this one. We can't heal in this one. Interesting. Yeah, Louise is not really useful when you can't heal. We have two stacks, which is not enough. And this one, reduce macro heroes. Sure. We can do that. This team doesn't really utilize SFX or Asmodel, so that's why they also don't have a good build right now, because I just wanted to block more things and try to tank, and that Shaho died instantly. So maybe I'm wrong, maybe he's not really good in here. But then again, yeah, you need to have a fully imprinted team here. Unless you are relying on one hero to carry you, like a V4 Eloise or SFX. So he's probably way better in late game comps. Not really working for me right now. And this is the transcendence wave. Asmodel is gaining precision. We can't block him. And yeah, the counterattacks just kill us. Shaho is dead. He got one stack off. Like, as you can see, if you can't tank them, a Rogan is way better. The fact that you need to wait for enemies to hit you to gain buffs is not really good for tower or void vortex. So maybe for Realm's Gate he is good. But I don't see him working as good as a Rogan anywhere. Especially since Rogan is useful like in every mode, Broken Space, Void, whatever, like anywhere you can think of. Not that there are a lot of places, but you know what I mean. So I think that's enough for that. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.